Let's move off of Urban and let's give a brief early signing day discussion. How's that? I think that's okay. The best way to say it. I'm going to read off the top 10. We got A&M, Alabama, Georgia, 1, 2, 3. Then you got Ohio State at 4, Texas at 5, Penn State 6. That's a surprising class for James Franklin. Notre Dame 7, North Carolina 8, Michigan 9, Oklahoma 10. Surprising Oklahoma jumping in at 10 there with only 15 commits, but 12 of them are 4 stars. Hell of a job. Hell of a job keeping that class together for Brent Venables. Let's see, Mac Brown doing his thing, of course. Marcus Freeman doing it at Notre Dame. Overall, like A&M with the number one class thus far, which is so weird. Like, Chris, I'm so ready to be tired. Like, done. I'm done. I'm done with this early signing day crap because it's right in the middle of everything else. Like, I saw an article from Ross Dellinger who over at SI, and he said that the NCAA officials and the people that are actually at these institutions that can make a change are looking into this being the last early signing day. Like, they're just going to go back to February because it's too much. Like, it's just becoming too much. But, yeah, so the signing day numbers are not done yet because they still have through Friday to sign early, and then we still have the day in February. So we actually don't have any idea where we're going to go with this. But alas, off of my soapbox here, Deion Sanders kind of stole the headlines. Travis Hunter, number one recruit in the country, flips from Florida State to Jackson State. What was your initial impression of that?
I was shocked, but, I think it's exciting. I think it's good for college football. You know, I mean, he's going to go. The thing that I worry about, or I wonder how it's going to look, is let's say he plays 3 years there, okay, and then goes in the NFL draft. Will there be elite teams that are suspect of him playing just so low caliber talent across the board compared to what he would be going against in a Power Five where that would hurt him in the future?
So, one would rightfully assume that, I think. But on the other hand, we did see like Steve McNair at Alcorn, like he was drafted what, number 3 overall. Like if you got talent, you got talent.
And I understand that, but Steve McNair played quarterback, and that's a little bit different than playing. If he plays DB or receiver, we're going to have a different conversation.
Yeah, okay. I can maybe see where you're going with this. I will say
because
that
you can look at a quarterback just running through drills, and if he's got arm talent and he's got a live arm, but having instinct and skill to be able to hang with the best athletes in the world is totally different than having the instinct and the skills to shut down guys that, I mean, I'm not talking or even close to what D1, you know, wide receivers or DBs are like.
If he was going to Grambling or Tennessee State or somewhere like that, absolutely, for sure. But going to Jackson State, remember, Deion Sanders is still tied in very tight with the NFL community. I think that's actually probably going to help.
Yeah, but you're not going to get any game film from it for 3 years. That's basically what I'm saying. Okay,
yeah, you've got a coach
that everybody knows and everybody likes, but you're going to have zero game film for 3 years that anybody can trust at all.
Yeah, I mean,
also, you're not going to be challenged. So you're talking about having a race car that basically just takes pace laps for 3 years and then hoping they could go to the NFL and ramp that thing up to 11.
Well, I mean, he'll basically have, you know, one or two chances to really be able to do that, and that would be, you know, he's going to have the Army All-American game, which it's either that one or the Under Arm. I don't remember which one he's playing in, but either way. Outside of that, Senior Bowl, maybe, some of these other, you know, NFL Combine, something along those lines. He'll only have a few opportunities here and there to really show what he's capable of doing.
He won't play in the Senior Bowl because he probably won't come out as a senior. He'll come out as a junior.
Well, but if he comes out as a junior, like, why would you come out as a junior if you're not a first, second, third round pick?
Oh, no, he's still going to be that. I'm just telling you. No, I think he still has potential to be a first, second, third draft. I'm telling you that once he actually gets into the league, it ain't your rookie contract that makes you a lot of money. It ain't NIL in college that makes you life-changing generational money. It's your second contract in the NFL that changed your lives, your kids' lives, and your grandkids' lives for the future. If you aren't battle-tested for 3 years and all you do is go up against guys that couldn't come close to making any team that you play on. And then you have to go up against professionals. I think it's going to be shockwaves to the system. I'm not saying it's a bad thing that he did it. I'm just saying that it's a cautionary tale, because I could see 3-4 years from now when he gets into the league in 4 or 5 years. I think if it goes badly, it's going to be really hard for other NFL kids, for other kids to come behind him and do the same thing, because the scouts are going to not trust kids from HBCUs.
It may start a trend now, but that trend, as soon as he hits the NFL, if he is not successful, that will be a trend that dies pretty quickly. So we'll see what happens with it. Deion says there is no NIL bag. There's no none of that. He went on the ESPN morning radio show with Jay Will and whoever else is on that thing, and basically said, like, we ain't got no money. Like, he told him. He was like, $1.5 million, like, that's all a lie. Basically, it's people that are upset. They, as Stephen Godfrey would say, they got hurt butt. Like, that's basically what it is. So, it's
here's my thing.
Go ahead.
I think that's sad that he has to say that, by the way.
Oh, yeah.
Why is it wrong if the kid did get hurt? Like, all these people that are butt hurt, my thing is this. Florida State, how the hell do you not have a bag where you got out-bagged by a little B poor school in Mississippi?
Exactly. I don't think it was that. I don't think it's NIL at all. Florida State has a bag. Like, they got all kind of stuff that they can set up for him. What I'm trying to figure out is, like, if he wants to go and learn under Deion Sanders and learn how to be all of these different things, right? Like, Travis Hunter has been famous for several years now. If he wants to learn how to be famous and how to monetize that, how to capitalize on it. On the other side, like, people are talking about this with setting up new NCAA legislation and, like, people recommending all kind of shit. Look, this is not an NCAA school. Like, what are we talking about? Like, this whole thing is insane. They don't have to do the same thing that the NCAA does. It's ridiculous. Like, I don't get it.
But this is what happens, Gary. Whenever somebody who's a big boy doesn't get their way, they want to change the rules because it had to be unfair. This is what we've done in our country. This is what we've become. If I'm supposed to win and I don't win, the other side had to cheat.
Yeah, that's a Florida.
And then not only did they have to cheat, but I think we should change the rules now so they can't ever cheat like that again. This is what we do. If this is how the grown-ups act, if this is how our politicians act, the people who run our country, why in the hell would we expect anybody else to act differently?
Agreed. Last thing I want to hit on with signing day was Clemson. Only 13 players signed with Clemson. Like, this is, I'm not going to say that the hires were bad, because we don't know, but at the same time, like, it's a little tricky situation here. If you're not going to bring in transfers, only 13, and again, this is early signing day. They could be waiting till February, but, like, a lot of the kind of guys that Clemson is used to signing have already signed. Like, this is a bit of a strange situation. I will be curious to see if Dabo and that plan that he wants to stick to, if that is something that can be a winning formula going forward. Like, you kind of feel the same way?
Yeah, I mean, I'm curious. I mean, LSU didn't sign but, like, a few kids. So,
well, but
like,
that's a coaching change. Like, that's a head coaching change. Like, LSU doesn't even have two coordinators right now. Like, Clemson has the whole thing. Like, they got everybody that they need. LSU, you could totally understand it. Like, that first signing class for a new coach is one thing. But
can't you roll – but you get to roll those scholarships over, right? Like, if you don't –
yeah.
I've listened to a guy that was talking about LSU. Like, if LSU doesn't sign their full 22, like, if they only sign 15, like, they get to sign, like, 28 next year.
Well, I mean, like, they'll get to sign 32 for, like, the next – 3 years or something like that. I mean, it's something crazy.
So it's fine. Like, if you didn't have the guys and these new coordinators that just came in, you know, aren't established, but, like, next year, you know, they will be established and you think we're good, then you go all in next year and you just try to start building them.
The other part of this is LSU has never said that they are not in on transfers. Like, I think Brian Kelly he's going to factor heavily into the transfer portal.
No, you're 100% right. Now, the transfers don't really affect that, you know, 22 number. So,
Well, 247 now has an overall, you know, that counts transfers. That just went into effect yesterday. So it's pretty interesting that not a whole lot of movement within the transfer. Thanks for listening to the Winning Cures Everything podcast. The website is winningcureseverything.com. And if you want to connect with us, we're on Twitter at GaryWCE, at ChrisBGiannini, at Winning Cures, or you can email us, Gary at winningcureseverything.com or Chris at winningcureseverything.com. Subscribe everywhere you need to subscribe, and we'll see you soon.